bringing in the parent coach, Karen Gibson. Thank you for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me here.
Today's topic is something that I and most parents struggle with at times. I'm going to just go ahead and start off with a loaded question. Is that okay with you?
Sure. Bring it on.
Why do children seem to make it their goal to argue? Bingo.
Doesn't it seem that way? Well, if kids don't feel heard, right? They don't feel understood or they feel judged. Their primary goal is going to be to use their voices, make themselves feel heard, which means they want the parent to seem wrong and they want to be right. So when you encounter this kind of situation, the best thing to do is not give in to this emotional, you know, you just get into this power play. You really have to understand that your child just wants to be heard in a safe place. And the secret, ready, John, is to learn your child's love language. Have you ever heard of love languages?
I have. And usually that's when you're talking about partners or couples.
Partners, yes.
I've never heard of this situation.
Believe it or not, if your child does not feel loved, they have more of a tendency to act up because they don't feel like the parents care, right? And you might be using the wrong love language. So I encourage all parents and kids, just go online, take a simple test, right? Just Google love languages quiz. There are 5 primary love languages. So it is usually, right, words of affirmation, acts of service, quality time, right? Physical touch or gifts. So if you are a person who craves, your child craves like a hug, a physical touch, but you give praise, your child may not feel loved, which means they might feel a little resentful. And that's when they might act out. So you think it is, you know, with couples, but children need to feel loved. And if you're not loved the way that you crave, you're going to feel like your parents don't care. And of course, you're going to act out to get attention.
Good to know. And not something that I ever considered with a child, particularly mine. I got another one for you. How do we handle the guilt that kind of overcomes us after we've argued with our child, with our Keiki?
I think that's the number one thing that just tugs at our soul, because then you feel guilty that you were mean or you said bad words or you just compare yourself with what you think a great parent would do, right? So you think, I'm not spending enough time with them, or I lost my temper. I didn't help him or her with their homework because you just didn't understand. So the key is just to know that it's perfectly normal. And oftentimes, if we don't practice self-care, our moods will be more, you know, your buttons will be quickly pushed. You won't be able to practice compassion and patience. So I strongly suggest some kind of self-care.
Here, how about this? Because there, I know there's a lot, times are different. I'm just going to say this. Times are different nowadays. What would you suggest parents do when a child decides to push the buttons? To push our buttons?
Happen? Yes, I feel that happens no matter what age your child is, 3 or 23, your child has a tendency, of course, it's when you're tired or stressed, right? And what a child needs, though, is less lecturing, more listening, and more love, because the way that you argue, your child, you're actually a role model. So what you do really impacts the way that your child will argue as an adult. So it's really important to, number one, which is the hardest thing to do, is don't argue back and walk away.
I know you have a pandemic parenting summit coming up. Can you briefly tell us a little bit about that real quick, and then how we can find out more information and get in touch with you? Could you do that for us?
I'm really excited about it. Yes, it's going to be September 18th, Saturday, Sunday, September 19th. It's 2 days from 10 a.m. till noon. And I think, like you said, it is parenting with a forever changing new normal. The parenting journey has changed. And I have 10 speakers. I have have someone from the UK who used to be part of the British Royal Navy, and now she helps people who are recovering from PTSD. I have a child psychologist. I have a memory trainer who is from Israel, right? When we really, if we don't remember certain facts or just utilize our memory with our kids, that's also going to affect just parenting. And then I also have the principal from Kanoʻalani Elementary School. So I have 10 experts from around the world who will help parenting, you know, just parent with less stress and more peace, which is my mission.
Thank you so much for being with us. I appreciate it. Great. That's great advice. A lot of good tips in there. And of course, it's coming from the parent coach.